just sunny days on each of the cemetery gates. Kids and the aides are on your side. Just sunny days on each of the cemetery gates. Kids and the aides are on your side. Wow, wow, it is on mine. So I go inside and we greatly read the stones. All those people, all those lives, where are they now? The loves, the hates, and passions just like mine. They were born and then they lived and then they died. Which seems so unfair and I want to cry. You say a thrice salutation to the dawn. And you claim these words as your own. But I've read them well and I've heard them said 100 times, maybe less, maybe more. Dead sunny days, so I'll meet you at the cemetery gates. Kids and the aides are on your side. Dead sunny days, so I'll meet you at the cemetery gates.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you are having an amazing day. I styled temporary tattoos for my Halloween party, and I just thought I'd use them up for fun, so that is what that is. Today, as you can tell by the title, I'm going to be doing a little what's on my iPhone, a chance to be nostalgic for videos that I loved growing up in the YouTube era and the YouTube space. Tomorrow I'm going to a meet and greet for Kian and JC. I'm literally so excited. All their friends are going to be there. Crawford is going to DJ. I've always kind of wanted to, and I thought it'd be so cool to intermix it with a cover. And as you guys notice, I'm really taking time to cover artists that I love that I have not done before. Old Bethany Moda, when she would have videos where she would DIY candles, show you how to make your lunch for school. But I do watch a ton of ASMR, and so I see these kind of often in ASMR and all those things. It is from Captain EO, which is the short little sci-fi film that Michael Jackson was in at Disneyland. And I have the iPhone 11 in red. Red is my favorite color of all time, if you didn't know slash couldn't tell. And I also keep my Oyster card in here, which was my little card for the tube in England. My friend said I'm done with my meeting, so sing your heart out. My screensaver, you can see the date. I am filming this very much in advance. I'm so excited. After this, I'm gonna go to Target. I'm gonna go see the Bowie documentary at the movies. Very excited for my evening. If you didn't watch my Holmes Chapel Harry Styles video, this is in Holmes Chapel, Cheshire, England, and this is the bakery that Harry Styles worked at as a teenager. And I just thought it's a very beautiful picture, and that was one of the best days of my life. So yeah. My background saver is a picture of me and my friends in Scotland. Well, Scotland was one of my favorite places in the whole world, but I just think this picture is so beautiful because of the buildings and the rainbow coming down. This was right in the moment where I got to see snow falling for the first time. Top row, we have the basic phone, FaceTime, calendar, photos. Okay. Camera, clock, and I'm actually not the type of person who keeps a lot of alarms. If I set one alarm, I will wake up. Maps, weather, reminders, which my only reminders are to post my YouTube videos, which is kind of funny. I just like to make sure that I have all my days planned to do that. Notes, which I do use quite often, especially for song lyrics on the go and things like that. News, music, I do not use Apple Music. I don't really touch any of these apps kind of here in the middle. App Store, health, settings. Bible app, which I do look at the verse of the day every day. I used to be so much better about it. Folders, I'm not crazy and I don't have all of them organized in folders, but this is watching TV, so Hulu, Netflix, HBO Max, and Prime Video. Oh my gosh, in terms of Netflix, I really want to recommend to you guys The House. If you like stop motion animation, which you know I do, I really recommend this film. I watched it over the summer and it was amazing. I'm not really crazy about Netflix. They don't have a lot to watch. I just have it mainly for Stranger Things, and my family has it, but this movie was absolutely insane. This book of materialism, and it has like four stories built into one, so I really, really recommend that. And Helena Bonham Carter is one of the voices. Beautiful. But if in terms of my favorite streaming service / most watch, HBO Max, girl, I'm going on the Google app for every single thing that I need. Ever are my most used apps. So messages, obviously, Spotify, YouTube, and Waze. Waze is directions, and Waze is the best direction app ever. So you can have your settings as anything you want. Mine is set as boy band, so it sings me my directions, which I adore. And then obviously YouTube. My YouTube subscription is really mainly ASMR. And then you guys obviously know my channel. You are here right now. Would mean a lot if you subscribed. Also, I do have playlists where some of my videos are broken out into more specific categories, if that helps. And then also community, which I do post on, and I know you guys sometimes see and comment for updates and things like that. In terms of Spotify, I do want to talk about this because I was looking back at a lot of my old videos recently, and I used to show you guys / recommend a bunch of new music, and I loved doing that. So I'm just gonna shout out a few things, not a lot. I always have my song of the moment down below in the description. So right now, my favorite song literally ever, please listen to Kill Her Freak Out by Samia. It came out yesterday, and I am over the moon in love, obsessed. She actually just released concert tickets today. I think I might snag one. She's been my comfort artist for so long. When you get passive, I like to imagine you listening to worship songs on your iPod. That's songwriting. Self-titled by Marcus Mumford. He's obviously the lead singer of Mumford & Sons. He came out with a solo album. It's absolutely amazing. I really recommend Dangerous Game with Claro and Stonecatcher with, of course, Phoebe. A little bit biased, but I think Stonecatcher is a beautiful, beautiful song. Troy recommendations. So he had two songs come out for a movie / show he was in. I'm not sure, I haven't seen it. Rubble and Wait from These Films by Troye Sivan. These have been my songs right now. Really, really, really recommend those. Sophie Cates. Please listen to Sophie Cates. I've loved Sophie for years, and she has kind of been my college memories. Me and my friends love to scream, sing her songs in the car. She's amazing when you just want to have that pop girl moment. Her song of her is Crowd. Hers is Crowd. I covered that song when I was in high school. It's an amazing song. I still listen to it almost every day, and it makes me really emotional. She just came out with a new song called Cardigan, which I love, and I also love her song Ghosts and her song Bad Mood, which I did mention in one of my other videos. But please listen to her. She's so much fun. Her song Football Game, also incredible. I had that as one of my song of the moments. Okay. Next is Chase Atlantic, Anything by them, and I know people are gonna judge me for this, but they make me so happy, and I'm not gonna feel bad about it anymore. And then also, please ignore Big Time Rush on my search. I have been listening to a lot of them lately. This one is embarrassing. I'm not gonna lie, it's embarrassing. Back in January, I had the virus, and I was staying in a hotel alone, and I was really bored, and I remember turning on Disney Channel, because Disney Channel is kind of a comfort channel, whatever, late at night if they're showing Jessie, like, it'll make you feel better. So I turn on Disney Channel, and they're showing Zombies, which apparently is, like, this generation's new Disney Channel original films movie. Obviously, I'm not keeping up anymore, because I'm 20 years old. I got really into it. Obviously, it's very corny, it's a kid's movie, but the first one was so good, and then I think there's three now, and there's a song in there called Someday. You're really gonna question my music credibility when I say this. This is such a fun song to me. I don't know why. I listen to it all the time. I love singing the girl part in the car. It's gonna be someday. Okay, I'm done. Next page, we have Files, Find My iPhone, iTunes Store, Translate. I don't touch any of these. Clips, iMovie, Safari. Again, I don't touch any of these. Wallet, boring, I don't touch that. A YouTube Studio, I do use a lot, which helps me look at my analytics for my YouTube channel. Shazam, I use all the time. I'm Shazamming every restaurant I go. This is my guitars folder, so Tabs, Ultimate Guitar, probably my fifth most used app. I've considered moving it down here because I'm on this app every day, all day, to learn songs. Guitar Tuner and Ukulele Tuner if I need it. Twitter, which Twitter is so much fun. This is my Twitter if you are not following and you would like to. I really just like to keep up with celebrity music news on this. That's why I have that, but I'm not crazy on social media. Apple support, remove the background. This is how I make thumbnails. It's a really big helper. Urban Outfitters app, love Urban Outfitters. LinkedIn, my Sprint, I don't know why. Oh, I think I had that when I went abroad to figure out my phone. Ipsy, I do get Ipsy boxes, which are so much fun. And this is, which is make a makeup subscription that's sent to you. And in this app, you can change your settings if you really want lipsticks all the time, if you have a different preference for shadow colors, stuff like that. Uber, which I've actually never Ubered in my entire life. I downloaded it for me and my friend at a concert, and we didn't even end up using it because an Uber just never came. AMC Theaters, Big Movie Girl, putting my hand over my heart. That was embarrassing. For Nicole Kidman's AMC ad. My Linktree, Google Maps, again, I don't really use it. Spanish Dict, which I use to study for my Spanish class that I'm in. Minute Photo to print photos at CVS, because I do that very often. Rent the Runway, which is a really awesome, cool thing. I haven't done this in years, but what it is basically if you ever have a really fancy formal to go to or a dance. I did this for every single dance in high school, prom, everything. Instead of buying a dress at a store and then never wearing it again, you can rent designer dresses for the same price, and you just have like 5 days to wear it and send it back. For every single dance, and my dresses were outstanding. The Disneyland app, because I go to Disneyland a lot, and that helps me see time and waits. Etsy, if you know me, this app is dangerous. I'm ordering from Etsy way too much. Big Etsy girl. This is all money stuff, so I'm not gonna open it. Spotify for Artists is this guy right here, and that one helps me see my analytics and who's listening to me on Spotify. And then the one next to it is my analytics for who's listening to me on Apple Music. Next folder is editing. So I don't really edit a lot of my photos, so I don't really need all these apps. I only touch two of them. Darkroom and Photoleave I use all the time. I use them for my thumbnails, and if I'm ever posting a picture on Twitter, I only use those two because I love all my photos to be film grain. PicCollage I do use for thumbnails. I've had PicCollage since I was little kid. I used to run a One Direction account when I was younger, and I made everything on PicCollage, and I even posted on PicCollage. Like, I was big into that. Flow, which we all know what that is for. Depop, I do sell on Depop. If you guys want to follow my shop, I will pull it up right now. Looking at Depop, shopping on Depop, and having my own little store. My mom is in charge of shipping all my stuff out because we run it out of my home back home. But yeah, if you guys want to shop anything, it's in my link tree. Next to it is concerts. I go to concerts a lot, and it is a big part of my life. So I have StubHub, Access, Ticketmaster, Important, Eventbrite, and Fever. Fever has awesome stuff. I recommend signing up for their emails, especially if you live near a big city. They always have the coolest events put on. The O2, which is an arena in London, and then SeatGeek. I work at my school newspaper. So this is our website, Slack, which is how we communicate. This right here is like how we edit. I just put it in an app, and then Otter, which is where I record all my interviews on. Apartments.com, because I spend so much time looking for my future apartment on this. I have accounts and folders and everything saved. And then Universal Studios app, because I go to Universal Studios a lot as well, and that's just for me to look at show times and wait times. I'm actually going this Sunday, so I'll use that. And then I have BuzzFeed out here on alone. I rarely go on this app, you know, if we ever need a fun quiz to take or whatever. Me and my friend used to do these in high school all the time in class. Photos, I do have a few albums, such as the funniest texts I've ever received. I like will screenshot them and I have them in a folder. YouTube video thumbnails, so if I find something cute I want a thumbnail, I have a folder for that. Future apartment, where I have all my decor and things that I see online that I want for my apartment when I graduate college. I used to have a Harry Styles folder. I should probably bring that back, but it had like thousands of photos in it. Look at this super cute coaster that I stole from my mom. It's crocheted. Okay. I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to turn on your post notifications so that you don't miss any of my uploads. In my next video, I'm going to wait until I go to all of my Harry Styles concerts, and I'm going to kind of share a little concert diary and do a cover to another artist that I haven't done before that I love. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you soon. Bye.